Hi students, today I am discussing about the unit name is Cell Biology, class number 5, and the topic is Endoplasmic Reticulum. Endoplasmic reticulum or ER, K.R. Porter. K.R. Porter for the first time coined the word or coined the term ER or endoplasmic reticulum. The word endoplasmic reticulum was coined by the scientist K.R. Porter. And endoplasmic reticulum is a thread-like structures. Thread-like structures extending in the cytoplasm of the cell and arranged to form a cytoplasm of the cell and arranged to form a network-like structure. The network of thread-like structures present in the cytoplasm of the cell is called as ER or endoplasmic reticulum. This endoplasmic reticulum is associated with the ribosomes. Due to the presence or absence of ribosomes on the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum, the ER is divided into two types. First one is rough endoplasmic reticulum. And the second one is smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Depending upon the presence of ribosomes on the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum, the endoplasmic reticulum is of two types. First one is rough endoplasmic reticulum, that means ribosomes are present on the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum. Hence, this type of endoplasmic reticulum is called rough endoplasmic reticulum. Next, absence of the ribosomes on the surface of the ER or endoplasmic reticulum. Hence, the endoplasmic reticulum is smooth. Hence, this type of endoplasmic reticulum is called smooth endoplasmic reticulum. Next, functions. The functions of the endoplasmic reticulum is rough ER, rough endoplasmic reticulum or ER. The short form of rough endoplasmic reticulum is RER, and the short form of smooth endoplasmic reticulum is SER. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum, rough endoplasmic reticulum. Functions of rough endoplasmic reticulum. It involves in, actively involves in the protein synthesis and secretion. It involves in protein synthesis and secretion. This is the main function of endoplasmic reticulum. Next, rough endoplasmic reticulum. Next, functions of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. It involves in lipid synthesis. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum involves in lipid synthesis and steroid hormone synthesis. Steroidal hormone synthesis. This is the endoplasmic reticulum. 4 marks important question. Differentiate between the rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. First, endoplasmic reticulum means K.R. Porter reported or coined the term endoplasmic reticulum, and endoplasmic reticulum is a thread-like structure present in the cytoplasm of the cell and extending in the form of a network-like structure, a network of thread-like structures present in the cytoplasm of the cell is called endoplasmic reticulum. And these endoplasmic reticulum consists of ribosomes. By the presence or absence of ribosomes, endoplasmic reticulum is divided into two types. Rough endoplasmic reticulum, short form is RER, and second one is smooth endoplasmic reticulum and short form is SER. Rough endoplasmic reticulum means the endoplasmic reticulum consists of ribosomes. Ribosomes are present on the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum. Hence, the endoplasmic reticulum surface is rough. Hence, it is called rough endoplasmic reticulum. Next, absence of ribosomes on the surface of the endoplasmic reticulum. Hence, the surface is smooth. Hence, it is also called as smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The functions of RER is, it is actively involves for the synthesis of proteins and secretion. And smooth endoplasmic reticulum involves in lipid synthesis and steroid hormone synthesis. This is the endoplasmic reticulum. And now, describe the nucleosome, structure of nucleosome. Now briefly describe the nucleosomes. 4 marks, another important question. When viewed under the electron microscope, chromatin appears as an beads on string. When chromatin viewed under a electron microscope, the chromatin is appears as beads on string. The bead is now called as nucleosome. The nucleosome consists of a DNA. A negatively charged DNA is wrapped around a positively charged histone aptamer. Encircles the positively charged histone aptamer. Form the nucleosome. A typical nucleosome consists of a negatively charged DNA. The negatively charged DNA is wrapped around a positively charged histone aptamer to form the nucleosome. This is the structure of nucleosome. The round shaped structure is called histone aptamer, histone proteins. Histone aptamer. And they are surrounded by double stranded DNA. Next, and it is the H1 protein. A typical nucleosome contains 200 base pairs of DNA double helix. Is wrapped around the histone core or histone aptamer. Histone core to form a histone aptamer. The histone aptamer consists of two copies of each of four types. four types of histone proteins arranged in two copies to form a histone aptamer. The histone proteins like histone aptamer consists of two copies of each of four types of histone proteins. The histone proteins like H2A, H2B, H3 and H4. These are the four types of histone proteins. The total number of histone proteins are 8, total two copies H2A 2, H2B 2, H3 2, H4 2, total 8 histone proteins or 2 copies of 4 histone proteins are organized to form a histone aptamer. Next, the DNA that connects the two nucleosomes are interconnected with each other by the presence of a DNA. The DNA is called linker DNA. For example, this is a nucleosome and it is also another nucleosome. The two nucleosomes are interconnected with each other . This DNA is called as linker DNA. Next, another H1 protein. H1 protein is bind up to the DNA where they enter or leave. Enter or leaving of DNA. This is the nucleosome, structure of nucleosome. When viewed under the electron microscope, chromatin appears as an beads on string. The bead is now called as nucleosome. The DNA is negatively charged. The negatively charged DNA is wrapped around the positively charged histone aptamer to form a nucleosome. A typical nucleosome contains 200 base pairs of DNA, double helix. Next, this DNA is wrapped around the 8 histone proteins, a core of 8 histone proteins organized to form a histone aptamer. A histone aptamer consists of 2 copies of each of 4 types of histone proteins. The histone proteins like H2A, H2B, H3 and H4, 2 copies of 4 histone proteins are organized to form a histone aptamer. The DNA that connects the two nucleosomes, are interconnected with each other. This DNA is called as linker DNA. Next, another H1 protein. H1 protein is located between the two nucleosomes. These H1 protein binding to the where the DNA enter or leaving the DNA. This is the H1 protein and structure of nucleosomes.